come back from that Dax Vibes, I have to say you're doing yourself a great job. Should I say taking up in Bobby Wine's footsteps, or even much better? Now it's about that time we get into Derek Dasha's world, the Uganda movie ambassador, before we head into my world, that is One-on-One. Catch you in a few minutes.
Sometimes in life, we spend all the time trying to live other people's life. And along the way, we lose who we are by copying what other people are doing in their relationship.
I can't explain the words for my love towards you.
That bastard is not taking you anywhere.
It's a good surprise on a Monday. Only Monday I packed a bit, but this is nice.
Thinking it would work out for us, but yet to find out, that's not who we are after experiencing a great disappointment.
She's in love with some other man, so classy, a gentleman, not poor dogs like you.
Another awesome evening to be chilling, of course, with yours truly, the Ugandan movie ambassador, giving you an insightful info of what is happening in the Ugandan film industry. Now, before I get into any of that, a big thanks to, of course, Century Cinemax, the guys that give me this place to make sure that I bring you the latest of what is happening. But on the other hand, they do have the 3D glasses. So if you've not yet gotten yourself a copy, please make sure that you do come and get one of these. This is for the adults, goes for 10,000. Then we do have this one for the kids at only 8,000. And then the Avengers glasses. Hey, so if you're a fan of the Avengers and you need to get yourself one of these 20,000 Ugandan shillings, and you'll be part of the Moving On 3D cinema. Now, moving away from that, of course, we come back to the local scene. A couple of you have seen this series on your TVs. Some of you do have copies. Mistakes Girls Do. I'm sure it has more fans of males compared to the females. But I'll be talking to a cast right here, Deanne and Smith. How are you doing, Deanne?
I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm good. Good to have you on the show.
Thank you. Good to have you too.
Smith, how are you doing?
I'm doing good.
How is your life?
My life is okay.
You're just okay?
Just fine.
After appearing in the biggest cities, you are just fine.
I'm actually very, very fine.
Very, very fine. Interesting. Now, before we get into something else, Deanne, I want you to first break it down for me what the series is all about.
The Mistakes Girls Do, it's all about... It is mistakes girls do, what really girls go through in mostly their relationships, and how they break up, how they end up in a misery life because of the mistake that they did.
Coming to you, I want to understand your role in the series. Who do you play as? What do you do?
I act as Patrick, and Patrick is this one guy that has a sugar mommy, at the same time a normal girlfriend. Of his age. The drama comes in when this normal girlfriend feels like Patrick is not the guy he wants to be with. Feels like Patrick can't give in enough. Patrick is not enough, you know, man enough to provide, man enough to love her. So, and then, you know, she runs away. And after running away to some other person, whom later on she finds this, fell in love with her sister, then me, Patrick, I fall in love with her. A sugar mommy who was a friend to my family, yes, that I met at some point where we had like taken a long time without seeing each other. So we come into contact, and after coming to contact, she expresses feelings and love and, you know, and affection, and then she woo me into it. So after I fall into that trap and enjoy the things.
I feel like Patrick had the most interesting scenes in this series, is it? Not really.
Yeah,
why?
There are many, like for me and for other guys, we have very interesting series. Actually, everyone has a story to tell.
Tell me about your story. Who do you play as and what do you do?
Okay, I am Zoe. I am this humble girl and interesting, like she's so jolly. She falls in love with a violet guy, and the guy tries to beat her up.
Patrick seems to have the memories right. All right, yes, it is,
Yeah, so the guy is so violent, and I try to, not to bear it, I move on. When I move on, I bump into another guy, he's called Harry. So Kyle was so violent, so I decided to move on. And Harry is so loving, so caring, so...
But on the other hand, I don't know why the director made you move on. I feel like girls like violent guys, don't they?
But they keep on moving on. Yeah,
if you... how violent you are.
It depends how violent you are. Are you a violent person?
No, I am
the Smith, not the
no,
other,
Smith.
Not the Patrick
it depends,
guy.
It depends, man. It depends. depends on how my day has been at work.
Hey, so you just come and all of a sudden.
You know, these days we have people rioting every time.
Yes.
You go to look for money, don't find money.
Mm-hmm.
You come back home and someone is loving you.
Uh-huh. So you just love them in a violent way as well.
Tell them.
For me, in the Mistakes Girls Do, Kyle was so violent. Like, he did that continuously, like, all the time. I could bear it, and I could not move on because I loved him passionately. But when time went on, he kept on doing it, like, continuously. So I had to move on.
Here's a trailer to give you something that you definitely need to catch up and be part of.
Sometimes in life, we spend all the time trying to live other people's life. And along the way, we lose who we are by copying what other people are doing in their relationship.
I can't explain the words of my love towards you.
That bastard is not taking you anywhere.
It's a good surprise on a Monday. On a Monday, we're packed to beat, but this is nice.
Thinking it would work out for us, but yet to find out. That's not who we are after experiencing a great disappointment.
She's in love with some other man, so classy, a gentleman. Not poor dogs like you.
What? Is that what she told you?
These are the mistakes girls do.
I don't know if you know how many men out there are willing to give me millions.
Wait, Tasha.
Just to be in my presence.
Wait, Tasha, what? Other men, you don't have the audience to talk about other men right now. Fine, go to other men, they will give you the money you want.
You see, from the last time I met your sister, I've not spent a day or a minute without thinking about her.
We need this man! Okay, maybe we do need him, but we need his money.
You either tell me where you're from, or you go back to where you've been.
Are you okay, or are you too fighting?
Yes, lad.
I'm not stupid. You know I regret the 9 months I had to carry you in my womb.
Disrespect to one another. Cheating. Listening to rumors. Falling in love with sugar daddies. Undermining their partners. Fronting material things more than love. Forgetting that love is not a place to move in as you please, but a house you step in and decide never to leave. Love, faith, empathy, betrayal, disappointment.
Mikoyi, what take a big enemy? Gabriel Joe, I feel back from Okutuka.
These are the mistakes girls do.
How was your experience like during this series?
Because you're still shooting.
Yeah, I think this you're doing season two now?
Season two now.
Yes.
Yeah, it's been a long journey full of learning, you know, lessons, because, you know, you keep on learning every day. And I would give thumbs up to the guy, the main guy, the director, Mulinda Richard, because he's been a father, he's been a mentor, he's been there to advise me every time. Actually, the whole crew and the cast has been there for us. Like, he calls in the morning, calls you mid-morning, afternoon, evening, say good night to you so that you're in good shape, ask you where you can do it, helps you out. Actually, sometimes he gives you trials, like he makes you go through the trials before you shoot, you know. Not every director does that, basically. And the other thing is, it teaches you things like tricks to be used when to pull out a character. You know, sometimes you have your personal character, the Smith that is so known to, like, into sugar mummies,
yes.
And here he wants you to quemola yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it's not
so sugar mummy is like men who quemola.
Yes.
Is that from experience or from the movie?
No, from the movie. Research.
Smart wares,
eh? Okay, all right.
So basically, it's been a wonderful journey. I'm still working the work.
How long have you been in this industry?
That's a tough one.
Please don't tell me you were born an actor, because I've heard that enough times.
Truth be told, I wasn't, though. Back in school, I used to do some drama, you know, music, dance and drama, you know, the things of stage. But this is like camera rolling action.
Okay.
Okay. You know, it's not that something like stage thing. So coming to now close to 2 years.
Deanne, your experience during this project?
It is so awesome. It is so amazing. Like, it is my first TV series. I mean, it is my first project that I've worked on. And before I wasn't, okay, let me say it is my first time to be shooting, but it is such a great experience with my director. I've been in the movie industry for quite some good time, like 3 years, but I had not taken chance of acting, like appearing in the movie. I was so nervous in the camera, I couldn't, but my director kept on rehearsing. We do rehearsals, so we rehearse a lot, and it has kept me moving, like to face in the camera. I've faced many challenges, but I've tried to conquer them because of the shooting.
And I know. You know, acting in English is not
Let's go slow on that. So you guys are trying to say that English was a problem at some particular point?
No, actually, it's not a problem. You might know English, but when you face the camera, you cannot.
English just
script English. Yeah.
Script
is
English.
Different.
It's so different. Yes. You have to read the script and act according to the script.
The emotions.
Yes. The emotions, they're okay because I'm an actor and I'm talented on that. But typing, I'm not talented on speaking in English. So if you give me a script, it is really so challenging. So
the
good thing,
when you grew up not speaking English, then acting in English brings
Smith
in
has a lot of life experience with English.
I know, but this is an amazing project, and I'm really so feeling amazed and honored to my director, director Melinda Richard. He has given us chance to portray what we're passing through, and according to the mistakes that girls do, you might find that the role that you're given, it is actually what you're going through. Yes, so you actually know what you're portraying. Yes, please. So it is really so amazing, and big ups to my director Richard, Rinda, Andy, and all my cast. I love the scene when Ari was trying to caress me and all that. You know, it feels real weird. It is not you. You're trying to kiss someone you don't love, actually at heart, but you're trying to act. We caressed, hugged, kissed, and all that.
Did you enjoy it?
No.
You did enjoy Deanne?
I was acting. I didn't enjoy, but
for
I felt
the that she
yeah,
did.
For that sake, Zoe enjoyed, but Deanne did not. I should say.
Did you plan on taking it a notch higher after the shoot?
No way. No.
You didn't.
No way.
Who was this guy?
Harry.
Smith. What was your best highlight during the production, or even during this production of season 2?
Okay, there's this one moment when Kathy, you know the sugar mommy is called Kathy. So when Kathy is at my apartment, and then I sleep with Kathy, you know. Actually, it was a hotel. So I tell Kathy, mom is worried about me. You know, I'm all worried in the morning, and Kathy tells me everything will be okay. So she tells me, don't have to worry about mom no more, you know. Everything is going to be fine. I'll buy you stuff. I'll take care of you.
Like
yes, like a baby. Like I kind of felt like I'm a baby at that moment.
Mm.
And then she takes me back to bed. Nice.
It's an interesting one, really, of course, and if we're to get into the details of this conversation, we may never cease to stop talking about it. But just feel free to get in touch with Richard Mlindwa. Just get over to his Facebook page, send him an inbox, tell him that you need to grab yourself a copy of this series, and who knows?
The
page is called?
Limit Production.
Okay, just get there, Limit Production, Mystics Girls Do, just send them a message, and I'm sure they'll be glad to deliver this interesting series. I'll see you guys on the timeline just after I catch my best movie in Dolby Atmos right here at Century Cinemax.